Hi everyone, it's Allison from the Protocase team. Today I'm going to talk to you about sub-assemblies. If you haven't already, I recommend watching our beginner tutorial on sub-assemblies and how to create one and save it in your personal library. Since putting out that tutorial, we've actually improved the sub-assembly feature. So now you can specify how you'd like your sub-assembly attached to your enclosure, panel, or part. So today's tutorial is going to show you how to add a sub-assembly to an enclosure and go over everything you need to know about providing our engineering team instructions on how you actually want it to be attached. But first, let's do a quick tutorial on how to create a sub-assembly. I've got my flanged bracket that I've created with two mounting holes. To save it as a sub-assembly, you first need to have the mating face positioned so that you can click on it. So I'm just going to rotate this here. Then click on Cutout Library Manager and select Create Sub-Assembly from the drop-down menu, or use the Sub-Assembly button on the left-hand side. So here you can change the name and other identifying characteristics about the sub-assembly. Once you click OK, you'll receive confirmation that your sub-assembly has been saved. When you click on Cutout Library Manager, then open Cutout Manager, you'll be able to see the sub-assembly that you created in your personal library. So now, let's get into how to attach your sub-assembly. I've got an L-shaped enclosure to which I want to attach the flange bracket that I previously created as a sub-assembly onto the base. I'm going to click on Edit Face and select the inside face of the L-shaped enclosure. Okay, so now I'm in the face editor. From here, I need to click on Cutout Library and Fasteners. Scroll down to Personal Library, which will display all of my custom cutouts and assemblies. You can also open the full cutout library to see your personal cutout library. I'm going to select my flange bracket and then place it on my enclosure. Now Protocase Designer is asking me how I would like to attach my sub-assembly to my enclosure. So we can attach your sub-assembly here at Protocase either by welding or using self-clinching fasteners. Click on the Welds Radio button if you'd like to choose welding. Use the notes section to give our engineering and design services team more details on the preferences you have when it comes to welding. For example, this is where you should note if you prefer tack welds, plug welds, or if you don't really have any preference at all. You'll also see that Protocase Designer advises you to make notes of any exclusion or keep out zones. Ideally, you would do this by creating exclusion zones within the face editor. We can also attach your sub-assembly using self-clinching fasteners. Similar to welding, you can use the notes section of this dialog to give us as much information as possible about your preferences. If you have a specific type of fastener you'd like to use, whether it's nuts, studs, or standoffs, this is a place to let us know. Include all of the key information, including part number, thread size, length, and more. And if you really don't have a preference as to which fastener is used to attach your sub-assembly, you can also let us know here. So the same guidelines apply here for any areas that should be excluded. The best way to ensure our engineering and design services team is aware of these exclusion areas is to actually create an exclusion zone using the face editor. You'll notice there's one other option besides welding and self-clinching fasteners. You can select Other. So this is the option to choose if you'd prefer to attach your sub-assembly yourself once you actually receive your order. Once you've made all of your notes according to your preferences, click Accept, then the green check mark to save all of your changes. If you attach more than one sub-assembly on a face, or if you're even attaching another sub-assembly to a different face, you can choose a different attachment method for each sub-assembly. Protocase Designer auto-saves the most recent attachment choice and any notes, but you can change that for any new assembly you attach by selecting the correct attachment option and then inputting your new note as required. So once you actually order your design and it goes into production to be made by the team here at Protocase, you may be contacted by a member of our engineering and design services team. They may need more information or want to clarify any details about how your sub-assembly needs to be attached. And that's all you need to know about attaching a sub-assembly to your enclosure, panel, or part. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave a comment below, email us at info@protocasedesigner.com, or reach out on the Protocase Designer forum. Thanks for watching, and happy designing.